Hi guys, and welcome to next video from Mini Bike Store. Today's video will be very technical. I will be showing you all the connections in the electric Mini ATV. This is very similar to electric pocket bike or electric mini dirt bike, but here I have removed all the plastic from the brand new ATV. This is the Replay 1200 watt 48 volt electric mini quad. So in today's video you will understand how everything is connected, how the batteries are connected, all the plugs to controller, so the throttle, the switches, lights, brake lights, even the alarm, as this ATV it also comes with the remote controls and alarm. This mini electric quad is the full option, so you have the front LED lights, there is a tail light with the brake light as well, there is a horn, you have the horn here, you have the lights, there is a brake light as well. When you press the brake, the rear light will light on as well. So there is also remote control with built-in alarm. So you can operate, turn on and turn off the quad remotely. This is a very nice feature. So let's explain me how everything is connected. So first let's start from the batteries. Here you have the main cable coming from the battery to controller. That's the one here. This one here. On the red cable you will have the box with the main fuse. That's where the main fuse is located. Now, to connect the batteries, in this case we have four batteries as it is 48 volt. You may also have only three batteries. So this is how you connect the batteries. From the first battery, the positive goes with the red cable directly to the controller. Then the negative goes to positive on the second battery. Then from the negative on the second battery, you have to connect the third battery with the positive, and again from the negative from the third battery to the fourth battery go to positive, and then the negative from the fourth battery goes to controller as well, and in this way you will get 48 volt output on these two cables. So controller is receiving 48 volts, not only 12. Next, let's look to the switch on the top here. This switch is to change the gear. You can change from forward to neutral and reverse. This switch changes the polarity from the negative to positive and the other way. So basically when you turn this switch forward, on the output on the switch, on the red cable you get the positive, and on the black cable you will get the negative. When you turn the switch into the neutral, then there will be no power at the cables at all. And when you change the switch to reverse, there will be positive on the black cable and negative on the red cable. And then the motor will run the other way. Here you can see how the switch is connected to controller. From the controller you have the blue cable and is connected here, and the yellow cable is connected here. If you own pocket bike or dirt bike, this blue and yellow cables will be connected directly with these two cables going to motor, as you will not change the gear from forward to reverse. It will only run the one way. If it happens that you replace the controller and the bike will run the backwards, then you simply need to swap these two cables in the plug, and then the bike will run forward. On both brake levers, just here and here, are the safety sensors. These sensors are very important. It works like when the child presses the brake lever and keeps the throttle on. Even if he has the throttle on, the brake will disconnect the motor and the quad will stop. These brake levers are connected to controller just here. When you disconnect it, you will see the plugs on the controller are marked as brake. Usually there are three plugs with the mark as brake. You will find one more here. Oh, you see, it's empty. This plug is used for quads if you have a foot switch. Sometimes for safety they also comes with the foot switch. So you can connect the foot switch into the third brake plug. In this quad, this plug is just empty. Next, we look into the twist throttle. This works the same like in the standard motorbikes. It is always like this in the all mini electric pocket bikes, quads and the mini dirt bikes. This one here, it's a three function one. So the first function, it is twist throttle, so it accelerates when you twist it. The second function is the key switch, so when you turn the key, the whole quad will turn on. And the third function is the battery status display. So in this model we have three plugs. One will be for the throttle, one will be for the key, and one will be for the display. So let's see how it's connected to the controller. So here it is, how it is connected to the controller. So first function is the twist throttle. This is always the three cable plug. When you disconnect it, you can see it says throttle on it. This is only for twist throttle. Then we have the next plug, this one here, which is power switch. It can be also ignition or power lock. This is for the key switch. The third function, this plug here, is for the battery display. And when you disconnect it says throttle. It can also say battery display, but it has to be red. The red plug means that from controller, in this plug there is 48 volt. On white controllers there is a low voltage. On the red ones there is always 48 volt, or if you have 36 volt quad, there will be 36 volt on this plug. So these plugs are high voltage plugs. In the new models, they are marked as red color. So let's connect it back. Next important equipment is the charging port. Usually there is only one charging port on the mini electric quads, but there can be also second one built in directly on the battery. So if you have a quick change battery, you may have the charging port built in on the battery, and then there will be one more built in on the frame. The one on the battery will be connected directly to the battery, but if you have one built in on the frame, this also is connected to the controller, and the charging is going through the controller. And it is connected just here, and on the plug it will say charge. That's where you connect the charging port. When you're connecting the charging port, you need to make sure the black wire match the black wire and the red match the red wire. This is very important. Now let's look to the next switch. This switch is actually built in most of the mini electric quads and the mini pocket bikes, mini dirt bikes. With this switch you can actually change the maximum speed settings. So we have three different speed settings here. Every time you change the setting, you can remove the key and the child will be able to change the speed setting himself. This switch is connected directly to the controller. From the controller you will find four long cables, two black ones and one orange and yellow, and this is how you connect it. Next, let's move to the alarm system in the quad. This one is equipped with the remote controls and the alarm. Not all of the mini electric quads are equipped with this function. This is really nice function. You can turn on and turn off the quad. So now see the quad is on. You can simply turn it off. Oh, it's not working anymore. So this is nice for parents. This function is really, really cool. Here it is how the alarm looks like. There is a black box and a siren on the top. There is not many cables coming from it. The black one here is just the antenna, it's not connected anywhere. Then we have the cables which connect the black box with the siren. And then we have the three cables going to controller. So you need to make sure that on your controller there is a plug marked as alarm. This plug is also marked as red color. So this is 48 volt high voltage plug. So make sure the alarm, it's the same voltage as your quad. It can be a 36 or 48 volt, but the voltage of the alarm must match your quad because it's connected directly to the high voltage of your quad. In this case, it's 48 volt. This quad is also equipped with the horn and the lights. Here are the front LED lights and the rear light. It also have the brake light. So let me explain to you how everything is connected. So these cables here are for the lights. This cable connected to controller, and this is marked as indicator. This is also red, so it's a 48 volt in this case going to the lights. So all the LED lights and the horn, all is 48 volt. You need to make sure this is high voltage connector and make sure the lights are the correct voltage. Here where you connect it, you power on the lights and you power on the horn. So positive is always on the lights and always on the horn. Then we have the switch cables here. This is where switch is switching on and switching off the horn and the lights. The switch for the horn and the lights are on the left hand side on the handlebars. Here is the horn button and the light switch. One is for the horn and one for the lights. Here we have the negative. The negative is going to the switch. And then there is an open closed circuit which opens or close the negative going to the lights. And this makes the lights to turn on and turn off. And the positive is continuously set going to the lights, the rear light, and in this case we have two front lights. So once here we have the positive going to the directly to the light, and here we have the negative going from the switch, which opens in the switch or close in the switch. So once we have the negative, once there is no negative. So the light is turning on or turning off. The same story with the rear light. They are all connected here in this bunch of cables. And there is also a brake light just here from the controller. The plug is marked as brake lights. It's a white color. This is very low voltage. This plug only gives the negative to the brake light. So once you press the brake lever, the negative will fly through this cable going to the tail light, and the brake light will light. All lights and horn are connected just to one plug. This is where positive and negative is coming. This is high voltage one, 48 volt. The positive is always in the lights and in the horn, and the switch only opens or closes the negative. You can see yourself that connecting the mini electric quad is not very difficult. Once you know the basics, if you need to replace the controller, each plug on the controller should be marked. If you will get the controller with the red plugs, this is a high voltage. The red plugs usually goes to the battery display, goes to the LED lights, horn and alarm if you have one in your quad. All parts for this mini electric quads and pocket bikes, dirt bikes, we always stock in our shop, minibikes.store. So you can always visit our shop and get the parts you need. We ship to all EU countries, so you will get the parts very quick and you can repair your electric mini ATV or pocket bike or mini dirt bike. Thanks for watching. In the next video I will make the video how to actually test every equipment on the mini electric quad. So if you get any trouble, the quad is not working by some reason, I will show you in the next video step by step what to do, how to check and find where is the problem with your electric mini ATV or mini electric dirt bike or pocket bike. So thanks guys for watching, and I see you in the next video.